never saw this morning or spoke to. And happy Mother's Day to all the mothers today. And we hope you enjoy your day. Today is your day. Amen. All right, I want to call your attention to 1 Corinthians, the second chapter. 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, verse 9, 10, and 11. 1 Corinthians, second chapter, verses 9 through 11. You have it, and if you can stand. If you can't, we understand. We haven't made it there yet. But we keep a living, as old folks say, we gonna get there. Right? All right, y'all. That's right. We ain't got there yet, but we're going to get there. We'll keep it there. 1 Corinthians 2nd chapter, beginning verse 9, it reads thus. But as it is written, eyes have not seen, ears heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the thing which God has prepared for him that love him. But God has revealed them unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God. For what man knoweth the spirit of a man, save the spirit of a man which is in him? Even so the things of God knoweth no man, but the Spirit of God. I read you the same word, may the Lord have a blessing to the hearers and the doers of his word.
Amen.
All right. Y'all hear me? Do remember me, yes, do Lord, do remember me. I said, do Lord, do remember me.
final word of prayer. Eternal Father, Father in heaven, we thank you, oh God, for this hour, for this very minute in time. Oh God, you woke us up this morning in our right mind, with shelter, food, and with clothes on our back, shoes on our feet, God. We said thank you. Realize the Master, we could have been sleeping in our graves this morning, but by your grace and your mercy, you made it so. So God, now we are here in this place of worship. We pray that you would take us out of ourselves and allow us, put it in our minds and our hearts, and let your Holy Spirit lead us this morning. We pray, God, that you would deliver us from anything that might hinder us from receiving what you have for us this morning. We thank you, Master, for everything you have done for us throughout our life up to this very minute. Thank you for your grace, your mercy. Thank you for saving us. Thank you for what Jesus Christ did on the cross over 2,000 years ago. Just for red little wretches like us. Pray, Master, that your spirit will move in this place this morning. Realizing, God, that this could be our last day, last time here. So we're going to praise you and lift you up like it may be our last time. Oh God, we thank you for the mothers that you have placed in our lives. For the ones that are here and the ones that are gone. For what they meant in our homes, what they meant in our communities, and what they mean in our churches. Realize that God put them here to take care of our kids, put them here to take care of the men folks. And then some that didn't have kids, they still took care of things that you told them to do. So we just lift them up to you this morning, God. We pray that you continue to bless them and see you fit. We pray for this entire congregation this morning. Don't know, God, somebody might be here this morning that might need something special. We pray that they will receive it this morning. Just move in each one of our lives this morning, God, so that when we leave this building, we will be better than we were when we came in. And for the man that's going to speak this morning, we lift him up to you. Fix the door of his mind. Concentrate, God, deliver the word that you have placed on his heart. We pray for each auxiliary, this church. Then we pray for each church throughout our community. Then we pray for those who are less fortunate this morning. We pray for our young folks throughout our communities. We pray for the bereaved families. We pray for the elders. We pray for the widow. Oh, God, we need you in this time, in this period of history. So much meanness and hatred and division. We realize, God, that because so many have turned their backs on you. So fix our hearts and our minds that when we leave this place and go our separate ways, destination, that we folks will see you in us as we carry ourselves as Christians should. So God, we thank you for everything you've done. We pray that you would bless this service. We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. And ask it all.
with you.
Amen.
And the visitors who would like to stand, you don't have to stand if they just want to recognize the visitors who would just like to stand. Okay.
Amen.
Thank you for coming anyway. Glad you chose St. John.
Amen.
Glad you decided to come to the service with your family and with us.
Right.
Amen.
On our prayer list, we have Sister Sinners, first of all. We've been informed that her medication is not working quite as well. But just pray for her.
Amen.
Okay, keep her in your prayers.
Amen.
Pray for Deacon Williams and family, Brother Blacklock and family, Sister Johnson and family, the McAllister family, the Jerry family, Deacon and Sister Brooks and family, and Minister Grace. He's not here today. But just pray for every one of your saints.
Amen.
Announcement, revival, May 12th through 13th, 7:30 p.m. at Restoration Missionary Baptist Church, Rebuilding Life for Christ. And this is Longview, Reverend Carvell Davis, the pastor. And like I said, it's two nights, May 12th and 13th, 7:30 p.m. nightly. Grant County Democratic Party, 2113 South East Monroe, Longview. You are invited to a Democratic Forum Thursday, May 12th at 6 p.m. New Life Outreach Church, 1801 South Marbley and Verso. We are preparing you for the May 24, 2022 runoff election. Local, state, and congressional candidates are participating in this exciting event. You will be able to learn more about this new election law and voting poll. Meet your county and precinct chair. And thank you so much. I hope you have a wonderful day. And again, happy Mother's Day again to all the mothers. Thank you.
Amen. We are to our tithes and offering at this time. Deacon, if you will. Thank you for those who gave into the offering. We pray for those who gave, being obedient of your holy and divine word. We just want to say thank you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
a world filled with sin and darkness. We need to know that you still is the light of the world. We know you performed miracles back then in Old Testament times, but you're still the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. So speak to us today, Lord God. Help us to leave this place better than what we came in here today, Lord God. We came in with expectations, Lord God. We came in to hear a word from you, Lord God. Speak to us today, Lord God. Help us today, Lord God. Use this man in a mighty way, Lord God. Help us today and help us. We thank you. We praise you. We magnify you and glorify you. It's in the mighty, precious, and powerful name of Jesus we pray and ask it all. Amen.
Thank you. Mothers, we thank you for the days that you have done for all of us in our lives. pray, God, that you just wrap your arms around them and bless them in a mighty special way. And we know you have, because you're God and can do all things. So have mercy upon them in the name of Jesus. These families that come home to be with their mother, their grandmother, their aunt, or whoever it is, God, we pray that you just bless them in a mighty special way. And we thank you, God, for the things you've done for us. But then first of all, we want to go back, God, and we want to ask you to forgive us of our many sins. And God, we ask that you will create in us a clean heart and renew the spirit within us, the right spirit, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Master, and then we love you. And then we pray that you bind Satan from our midst. We thank you for the quiet songs, quiet songs, and musicians playing the preacher, and deacons doing the devotions, and others on their post, and the congregation is here, God. And I pray that you bless your word today. I pray, God, that you will strip me of sin. Allow your word to come through, God. That someone will hear your word. Do things which is pleasing to your sight. Teach us, Master, to number our days. Teach us, God, to look at your word and know, Master, that things are changing. Things are not like they used to be. So we ask that you would have mercy upon each and every one of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, God, to the church, family, the relatives, our brothers and our sisters. We want to say thank you.
Amen.
Your brother Boyd, we thank you. Amen.
Amen.
You did a beautiful job. Told him back there, boy, I gotta get out of here and hear this morning. Amen. And the choir, you sing fine songs. Amen. I don't want us to forget that this is Mother's Day. Amen. To the world family, good to see you all. Amen. Genesis 18.